Once again, welcome to class number 3. So in the previous class, we have discussed derivative of analytic functions. So only Cartesian form we have discussed there. So here we will consider functions involving polar form. So first problem I am going to consider is prove that f of z equal to z power n is analytic. F of z equal to z power n is analytic, and find its derivative. Solution. So given f of z equal to z power n. See, here we have f of z equal to z power n. Either you can use z equal to x plus I y or z equal to r into e power I theta, no matter. You can use any of that two forms. But see, if you use x plus I y, the Cartesian form, then it will be f of z equal to x plus I y whole power n. So expanding that, you get n plus 1 number of terms involving binomial coefficients. That will be difficult. So we don't take z equal to x plus I y. So we'll take z equal to r into e power I theta. So that will be easy to handle. So then f of z equal to r e power I theta whole power n, which is r power n into e power I n theta. Now we have to use de Moivre's theorem. De Moivre's theorem says that cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n equal to cos n theta plus I sin n theta. So okay, I'll write here, then it will be clear to you. See, it will be r power n plus e power I theta whole power n. You can write this as e power I theta whole power n. So it will be cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n. See, this we can write as r power n into e power I theta whole power n. E power I theta is cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n. Now applying de Moivre's theorem here, it will be, sorry, this is into r power n into cos n theta plus I sin n theta. So we need to separate this into real and imaginary parts, right? So it will be r power n cos n theta plus I into r power n sin n theta. So we got f of z in the form u plus I v. So now u r u theta, v r v theta, these are the derivatives we need to determine. U r, what is u r? You have to take u and differentiate that with respect to r partially. So n into r power n minus 1 into cos n theta u theta. So r power n again, the derivative of cos n theta minus n sin n theta. So minus n into r power n sin n theta. V r, so n into r power n minus 1 into cos n theta. It is sin n theta only. V theta, r power n into cos n theta. Now I had to check CR equations. See, CR equations is r u r equal to v theta minus r v r equal to u theta. So I had to check whether this condition holds here. Now see, to check CR equations, r u r equal to, see, u r is n into r power n minus 1 into cos n theta. Multiplying r to this, it will be n into r power n minus 1 remove out the cos n theta. That is same as v theta. Similarly, minus r into v r, vr ke minus r multiply madu so idike minus r multiply madidre minus id r power n minus 1 irudhu r power n agutte so it will be minus n into r power n sin n theta so that is same as u theta so from these two the real and imaginary parts of the real and imaginary parts of f of z satisfies CR equations so from that our conclusion is the function is analytic hence the function is analytic now we need to find its derivative the derivative of f of z is given by first you need to write the formula right f dash of z equal to e power minus I theta times ur plus I vr so f dash of z equal to ur that is okay e power minus I theta into ur antandre n into r power n minus 1 cos n theta plus I into vr antandre n into r power n minus 1 into sin n theta so I have just substituted for ur and vr now as I said already after substituting for derivatives you have to put r equal to z and theta equal to 0 you have to put r equal to z theta equal to 0 so f dash of z will be e power minus 0 that will be 1 n into z power n minus 1 into cos 0 is 1 plus I into n into z power n minus 1 into 0 so I will be getting f dash of z equal to n into z power n minus 1 n into z power n minus 1 so that is the derivative of given function f of z so the given function is z power n given function is z power n if you differentiate it you get n into z power n minus 1 so that you can actually guess easily so that's the first problem on polar form problem b show that f of z equal to log z z not equal to 0 is analytic I am find its derivative find f dash of z adho illi w anta kottidre dw by dz anta kottirtare just like the first problem we solved on cartesian form solution let f of z equal to log z let f of z equal to log z with z not equal to 0 now if I take z equal to x plus iy then simplifying log of a plus b you have to use the Taylor series expansion Taylor series expansion of log z that will be highly difficult to solve but if you take z equal to r into e power I theta then you can use log ab equal to log a plus log b formula so z equal to r into e power I theta so from that you get f of z equal to log of r into e power I theta so that is log r plus log e power I theta see log and e are inverse of each other So log of e power of x is x, and e power of log x is also equal to x. So they are inverse of each other. Log cancels with exponential and gives you the same input x. So we get f of z equal to log r plus I theta. Now the real part is log r and the imaginary part is I theta. See, this will be u and this will be v. Theta will be v. So don't consider I while taking v. U r equal to 1 by r. U theta equal to 0. V r equal to 0. V theta equal to 1. Now r into u r equal to 1. That is same as v theta. And r v r, that is 0. That is same as u theta. So from these two, what is our conclusion? CR equations holds. Thus, the given function is analytic. Thus, the given function is analytic. So, function is analytic. You can find its derivative using the formula. The derivative of f dash of f of z is given by f dash of z equal to e power minus I theta ur plus ivr, e power minus I theta times ur plus ivr. So that implies f dash of z equal to e power minus I theta, u r is 1 by r, right, plus I into v r is 0. So as usual, put r equal to z, theta equal to 0. Put r equal to z, theta equal to 0. Then f dash of z equal to e power 0 is 1 times 1 by z plus 0. So f dash of z is 1 by z, and it is already given that z is not equal to 0. So this derivative exists. So that completes the second problem on derivative of analytic functions. Problem C. Show that f of z equal to r plus k square divided by r cos theta plus I times of r minus k square by r sin theta, theta not equal to 0, is analytic. Okay, here there is one more word, regular function of z. Of z equal to r into e power I theta, that is also given. Okay, find f dash of z. Yes, this problem is most important in view of definition of analytic function. See, this word I forgot while defining the analytic function. So that we give as a note here. An analytic function is also called as a regular function. That is another name, that's all. Or holomorphic function. So this I forgot, we are defining analytic function, so keep this in mind. analytic function is sometimes called as a regular function, and also it is called as holomorphic function. So usually this may ask you for one mark solution. So here it is explicitly mentioned z equal to r into e power I theta. So there is no issue of explaining why we have to take only z equal to r into e power I theta. And given f of z equal to r plus k square by r cos theta plus I into r minus k square by r sin theta. Okay. Here it is not required to separate real and imaginary parts. The function given itself is in the form u plus iv. So it is not that step is resolved here. Simplification not necessary, only the given function is itself in the form of u plus iv. So directly you can find u and v, then verifies your equations, find its derivative. Now u r equal to 1 minus k square by r square cos theta, u theta equal to r plus k square by r sin k, it is minus alpha, minus sin theta. V r equal to 1 minus k square by r square, okay, plus alpha, 1 plus k square by r square sin theta. And v theta, 1 minus k square by r cos theta. Okay. Now r into u r equal to, now r u r equal to r minus k square by r into cos theta. That should be v theta, right? Okay, this one is r minus k square by r. Now it is correct. So that is same as v theta. Similarly, minus r v r equal to v r here. So multiply minus into this minus aage irli r olagade multiply agutte. So minus aage ittkolana r olagade multiply aadre r plus k square by r sin theta, that is same as q theta. So from these two, the real and imaginary parts of f of z satisfies CR equations. Thus the function is analytic. So the function is analytic, so we can find its derivative easily. The derivative of f of z is given by we have to write the formula, right? F dash of z equal to e power minus I theta into u r plus r into I v r. That implies f dash of z equal to e power minus I theta. U r means Yeah, I have to write down from here only. 1 minus k square by r square cos theta. 1 minus k square by r square cos theta. Plus I into Vr antara. So Vr means it will be, I think, 1 plus, okay, let me go over now. Vr, 1 plus k square by r square sin theta. 1 plus k square by r square sin theta. Now, close the bracket here. Now put r equal to z, theta equal to 0. If you put r equal to z and theta equal to 0 here, what we are going to get is f dash of z equal to e power 0 is 1, so no issue. So 1 minus k square by z square into cos theta is 1 plus sin theta, that will be 0. So f dash of z is 1 minus k square by z square. So this is the required answer. So with this, the solution, the discussion on derivative of analytic functions was completed, and next we need to move on to another concept. So the next concept is how to construct the analytic function or using CR equations. So in that sense, first we recall few definitions. Let u equal to, f of z equal to u plus iv be any function. We don't call it is analytic. Let f of z equal to u plus iv be any function. As usual, u and v represents real and imaginary parts of f of z. We say that, that is not about f of z. U double x plus u double y equal to 0. This identity we call as Laplace equation. Given any function in two variables, see, we can write actually f of z as, clear agala bekantandre, it should be written like this. U of x comma y plus I into V of x comma y. You should be right in this format. Both u and v are functions in x and y. We say that u double x plus u double y equal to 0, this identity as Laplace equation, where u is any function in two variables x and y. Similarly, we can write this. So given any function f of z, its real and imaginary parts are functions in x and y, then u double x plus u double y equal to 0, that identity we call as Laplace equation. So any function satisfying Laplace equation is called harmonic function. So here, if u double x plus u double y equal to 0, then this u will be harmonic function. And if v double x plus v double y equal to 0, then it will be harmonic function. Now, this is about, if the function is in terms of x and y, then it is correct. What happens if the function is in terms of r in theta? See, the Laplace equation for u equal to u of r comma theta is u double r plus 1 by r into u r plus 1 by r square into u double theta equal to 0. So this is the formula for, I mean, Laplace equation for function in terms of r and theta. So we have function u equal to u of x comma y. We say that, I mean, the Laplace equation is the identity u double x plus u double y equal to 0, or if the function is in terms of r and theta, u double r plus 1 by r into u r plus 1 by r square into u double theta equal to 0. So this is Laplace equation in polar form, Laplace equation in Cartesian form. Same thing you can extend for v also, even in terms of v variable. So any function, whether it is u or v or f, anything, any function that satisfies Laplace equation is called harmonic function, whether it is in polar form or Cartesian form, that is not a matter. So any function that satisfies harmonic equation is called, I mean, that satisfies the Laplace equation is called harmonic function. Now let us come to this one, f of z equal to u plus ib. See, related to this I have the concept analyticity, related to these two I have the concept harmonic. Now is there any relation between those two? That is the question. Have f of z equal to u plus ib, is there any relation between the harmonic functions and analytic functions? So there is one relation that is given by this. If f of z is analytic, if f of z is analytic, then its real and imaginary parts, then its real and imaginary parts are harmonic. See, f of z equal to u plus ib is analytic. This is analytic, implies, this is analytic, implies u comma v are harmonic. And it is obvious that converse need not be true. Even both u and v are two harmonic functions, then u plus iv need not be analytic. See, u comma v harmonic need not imply, need not imply u plus iv analytic. Okay, this is one most important you have to keep in mind. Second thing, if f of z equal to u plus iv is analytic, and then we say that real and imaginary parts are harmonic, and are called harmonic conjugate of each other, and are called harmonic conjugate of each other. See, if f of z equal to u plus iv is analytic, then u and v are harmonic. U is called harmonic conjugate of v, and v is called harmonic conjugate of u. So if you write f of z equal to u plus iv, then there exists some relationship between these u and v. They are not different, they have some relation between them. That is, one is the harmonic conjugate of the other. Moreover, you can get one from the other. That means, from u, you may obtain v. So, given any function u, you can get v. And then, you can get f of z. So, what I am saying is, given u, only u is given, say, only this much is given. Given u alone, we may get V. This should be harmonic. The harmonic I will make. Whenever U is harmonic, given U, you can get V. When you get V, then you can get U plus IV, that will be F of Z. So you can construct an analytic function whose real and imaginary parts are U and V. So this is about construction of analytic function that will be discussed in our next class. So all time being in a